After a long wait, the Mi 10 is finally here. Xiaomi India has new plans to infuse a fresh new lease of life into the Mi sub-brand, and the first device to be a part of that journey is of course the Mi 10. I know that when the Mi 10 launched, a lot of people had concerns about its supposedly high pricing. Now that we have the phone in our hands, maybe I can quell some of that fears. Hi, I'm Ashwar from Mr. Phone, and this is our unboxing of the newly launched Mi 10 and my first impressions of the same. But before we move on, don't forget to hit that red subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it to get notified whenever Mr. Phone puts out an awesome new tech video. Also, we're building communities over at Instagram and Telegram. Don't forget to check links to that community page in the description below. All right, so the Mi 10 box is here. This is the India variant of the Mi 10. And you can see that it still says 5G out here and 108 megapixel camera. And it's got the Xiaomi branding as well. Mi is making a comeback into the market. All right, so now what you can see behind are all the specs and the other features. This is the twilight gray variant. This is the 8GB, 128GB variant, which is available for around 50,000. The 256GB variant is available for slightly higher at 54,000 odd. And these are all the details that you get behind the box itself. And apart from that, nothing much out here, except for the fact that you also get the price and stuff, which unfortunately have been scratched up, but we know that already. All right, so let me quickly slide the top lid of the box and get this out, and let's see what's inside the box. So there is, first things first, a sheathing for what I'm guessing should be the case. Yes, of course, it is the case, but there also seems to be something else along with that. So let's take a look at that first. And this looks like a Type-C to 3.5mm dongle, and that's a rarity these days. So that's pretty cool. I'm glad that Xiaomi bundles that within the case, within the box itself, so I'll keep that aside. This seems to be a quick start guide of some sort. All right, that's aside. And this is the case. Let's take a look at the case right now and see, take a look at what kind of quality you get. Okay, this looks like a regular TPU case. Yep, it is that. Nothing too fancy out here. But it's got perforations, which makes it easier to hold. I'll put the phone in the case and show you guys what it looks like. But for now, let's just keep that aside quickly. And of course, get greeted by this gorgeous beauty of a smartphone. And take it out of the box and see what that looks like. Okay. Peeling the wrapper off. Always a good feeling. There you go. Looks pretty glossy if you ask me. Let me just take that out. It's a proper glass finish. And the quad camera array in full effect for you guys. Of course, it's got the 108 megapixel camera as well. And this gorgeous curved display on the front. Let me quickly switch that on and show you guys what the screen looks like. And then once again, I'll show you what the phone looks like in the bundled case. All right, so we've switched it on. Let me quickly put it in the case. And it's a really nice and snug fit. You could see it snap on there. I don't know if you heard it though, but this is how it looks inside the case itself. So I'll keep that aside for now and we'll take a look at the phone once again. But before that, let's take a look at what else you get inside the box. You do get a Type-C to Type-A cable. There you go. And it's got this orange accents going inside. That looks kind of cool if you ask me. So let me keep that aside as well. And after that, and you get this massive 30 watt charging brick inside. All right, you can see the details out here. Let me keep that aside. And this is all that you get inside the box of the Mi 10 India edition. There you go. So what you get are, of course, the phone itself. Let me actually take it out of the case right now and show you guys what it looks like apart from the other accessories that you get along with it. There you go. Once again, so you get the phone itself, you get the case, and you of course get the Type-C cable along with a 30 watt charging brick and a Type-C to 3.5 mm output. So there you go. So this is what you get inside the box of the Mi 10. Let's get down to our first impressions. Starting with the design, the Mi 10 oozes premium from all its curves. This glass slab looks extremely polished and refined. In fact, thanks to the curved front, I'm instantly reminded of the OnePlus 7T Pro. While the curvature is too pronounced, it makes it easier to hold in the hand and use. The back, however, attracts smudges easily. As for the rest of the design, you get a proper stereo speaker on the phone and it can get really loud. There is a Type-C port at the bottom and a dual SIM card tray as well, which is an exclusive India-only feature, by the way. Also, just to remind you, this is a proper 5G phone whenever that happens in India. Anyway, the camera setup on the rear definitely juts out quite a bit, but that's the norm these days anyway. The display on the front is a gorgeous 6.67-inch AMOLED panel with a 90Hz refresh rate and HDR 10+ support. But yes, in comparison to the OnePlus 8 Pro, the OnePlus 8 Pro definitely has a better panel, at least on paper. However, I found it odd that the hole punch camera on the front is not at the very corner on the left. It is tucked slightly inside to avoid the curve. The display also has the optical fingerprint scanner and it was extremely fast, no complaints. Oh, and before I forget, the haptic feedback is great too, but it is not Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra or iPhone level. The Mi 10 runs on MIUI 11 based on Android 10, but the awesome news here is that Xiaomi has decided to replace its very own phone dialer and messages apps with Google's alternatives. How cool is that? Also, you have access to the Google Discover feed in the minus one page. Again, bravo Xiaomi. However, not everything is hunky-dory. I don't know why Xiaomi had to pre-install apps such as Hello and those pointless games. Such bloatware feels unnecessary. Plus, the lock screen still has glance ads by default. Please switch it off. So the Mi 10 has four cameras on the rear. The headliner is the 108MP primary shooter though. I haven't had too much time to play around with the camera. However, from the few initial samples that I have, I can tell that the pixel bend samples are damn crisp. And the ultra wide angle camera and regular camera shots have color science parity too. I still need more time to evaluate the pictures. Until then, take a look at the samples on your screen. The Mi 10 has top-of-the-line specs in the form of Snapdragon 865, 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage, with an option of another variant which has 256GB of storage. I really wish Xiaomi India had brought the 12GB variant to India as well. Yes, along with the Mi 10 Pro, of course. I played a couple of games of COD and it was smooth as butter, and the refresh rate plus, you know, swiping through the home screens and stuff feels extremely smooth. I didn't expect any better either, considering the fact that you get Snapdragon 865 and such great specs. Plus, the storage is of the UFS 3.0 kind. Now, obviously, I still have time to test with respect to benchmarks and a few other features. I will get to that in my full review. The battery inside is a 4780 mAh unit, and I'm keen to check out how much it lasts on a single charge. Plus, you get support for 30W wired and, best of all, 30W wireless charging. This feature alone makes it desirable for a lot of folks. I can't give out any final verdict just yet, but the Mi 10 is shaping out to be one of the flagship phones to desire in 2020. I mean, changes to MIUI 11 alone make me very, very hopeful. So let's not go with any preconceived notions and keep an open mind about this, especially when you're talking about the price to performance ratio. So I would suggest that you wait for the full review. But of course, there are a couple of cons that I can see immediately, even in my first impressions, is that it comes with that 2-megapixel depth camera. I don't really know why you need that, and of course it doesn't have IP rating. So I will get to all of those things and put together a full review soon. That's it from me. I'm Ashar from Mr. Phone. I hope you guys like this video. Do let me know in the comment section below. Until next time, goodbye and Godspeed, my friends.